Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to construct a class diagram for online airline reservation system. And I'm going to do this entire task in StarUML. So let's get started. So first thing what you need to do is you need to go to StarUML and you need to go to model add diagram and just select the required diagram. So here we will be having a list of diagrams that we want to do. And in this video, we're going to do class diagram. So just set the class diagram option over here. By default, it appears. So if it isn't appearing for you, just go to model and select the class diagram. So here we are having the necessary shapes for drawing our class diagram. So I would like to have like 4 to 6 classes. Okay. So what are maybe the question? I would recommend you to have like 4 to 6 classes at least, because if you have like only 3 classes, your diagram will look like very blank, like very less in information. So I would recommend you to have at least 4 to 6 classes. So let's get started. So first, just click it and we are going to just press it over here. So whatever may be the class, we will be starting with the customer or the person who is going to use our system. So in place of like online airline system, it's going to be the passenger. So just type passenger in it. Okay, passenger, that's good. So let's just enlarge it. So now we are going to type the all the attributes and the operations that a particular passenger can perform coming to our site. So for just selecting the attributes, what we need to do is we need to just double click it. Just click it and can just type the attribute. So for a passenger, the first attribute is going to be name. Just type name and it's going to be of the type string, data type string. And just click this plus icon, you will be getting another attribute. And next one is going to be address. This is also is of the type string. Just type string and another icon. And next attribute is going to be gender. This is going to be of the type character, I would say, because we are just going to put M or F. So it's just a single character. If you are having like male or female, you can put a string. Both the case is fine. And next one is going to be age. So it's going to be of a type integer. Don't put float over there, because like age can be in decimal, but we don't usually represent decimal ages in websites or any other system. So just go with integer. And next one is going to be email ID. Email ID, that is going to be of the type string. And next one is going to be the phone number, which is also going to be of a type integer. I think this is fine. You can also add password and other stuff. That's okay. These are like the basic attributes of a passenger. I would like to have like 5 attributes and 5 passengers minimum for a main class, because passenger is like the most important class. Okay, so at least just fill it out. Okay, what are the things you are getting for a particular class, because we can't like get more number of attributes and operations for other classes. So if it's an easy class, if you are able to get more attributes, if you're able to think more operations, just fill it out. Okay, and next is going to be the operations. For operations, for adding the operations, it's all the same process. Just double click it, double click inside our class like this, and you'll be having this settings kind of option. Just click it, and the first operation that the passenger is going to perform is login. Okay, so in case the person, particular passenger is new, means you can also register. Okay, so actually register should come first. Okay, this should be register. Okay, register in case if it's a new passenger, means register should come first. After registering, we will be login. And next one is going to be view flights. Okay, view flights for a particular destination. Now this is then book tickets. Book tickets. And select the seats, which are the particular seat, which row and column. Select seats. And next one is going to be cancel tickets. And final thing is going to be logout, and that's it, I guess. So you can also add like check the availability of the flight, check flight status. Like if you have booked a ticket and you are in the airport, means there may be some delay in the flight arrival time. So you can just check the flight status, whether the flight has been cancelled due to some like weather conditions. That also comes under this check status. I hope like this is really good for the passenger. We have covered all the important stuff. So let's go on to the next class. Okay, have our next class. So just click class and just paste it over here. So our next class is going to be the flight itself. Okay, flight. Just enlarge it, and we are going to have attributes. Like just double click it and add attribute. First one is the flight name. Okay, so this is going to be of the type string. Okay, and our next attribute is the flight number. Every flight will have like a unique number. Same in case of our trains, we will have that announcement. So same thing goes for flight also. Flight number, this is also going to be of a type integer. Don't put float over here. Okay, and next one is going to be the flight status, which can be of a type string as well as boolean. I would recommend you to put string over there. And next one is flight capacity. This one basically will tell us about the how much seats are available in the flight. This is going to be of type integer. Vacant seats as well as book the seats. And next one is going to be the flight flight destinations. Okay, this basically covers the starting point of the flight to its destination. So flight, just put flight destinations for that. And next thing is going to be the operations for our flight class. So just double click it and go to operations. The first thing is timings. Okay, timings of the flight, update timings. So that all covers some central timings. And the flight status. Okay, so this also basically covers the delay. Is there any delay, whether the flight is coming in a quick time than predicted, or it's the flight has been cancelled due to some bad weather conditions. So that all the things comes over here. And next one is going to be notifications. Okay, so in case of like the flight has been like coming late, or in case of like any other problem, it can be directly notified to our passenger itself through the system. So I think this is really good for our flight class as well. So next thing, let's go to the next class. Okay, so next thing is going to be like the payment. Let's go for payment and just finish it, because payment is like the most common thing to do. Just go here and put payment. Payment comes in all the online systems, like same as passenger, customer. Customer and payment comes in like all systems. So for payment, you will just go here and add attribute like customer name of type string, customer ID, so type integer, card number also of the type integer, and next one is going to be card type, whether it's a debit or credit card. That's the first, the card type, that's going to be of the type string. That's it, these are going to be the types. And in case of like operations, we are going to have only one operation, that is make payment. Yeah, that's it. That is good for payment. Okay, so you can just add, if you want to add, you can just put transaction, check balance kind of stuff. I think like this is more than enough for payment. Next class is going to be the booking system. Okay, so this is like basically quite similar to our train system, where you can select the seats, we can check whether the flight is available or not. So it's going to be like a UI panel where we get all the information regarding our flight. We can just search and find stuff over there. So it's going to be a booking system. Okay, so we just expand it and just double click it and click attribute. Attribute is going to be the flight name. So using that, we can search the flight that we want to find flight name and starting location. Okay, that's going to be of the type string. And next one is going to be the destination, that is also going to be of the type string. And the date and time. Okay, date and time, you can put date as the data type. Okay, in there, date and time. And I guess that's it. We have like number of seats. Maybe can select the number of seats, that's going to be of a type integer. So these are like basically the things that we enter whenever we go for select aside. Number of players, that's it. So the operations that we can perform over here are same sign in, sign out, login, logout will come over here. We can just go over here and I think we forgot to add one over here. We can just add the important thing. We can just go for if passenger, we forgot to add make payment. Okay, that's the one thing we forgot, make payment. That's also quite important. So here in operation one, we can just go and select choose flight. Okay, and select the ticket, same operations as we added for user. Okay, select tickets. here also you add make payment. Make payment is going to get added over here, that's fine. And remove flight. Okay, if you want to remove or anything, remove flight. Modify. Okay, modify seats. And finally is cancel. Okay, cancel all the operations. You can just put a simple cancel, that's enough. So this is the booking system and flight. We have the payment, and next one is going to be the that particular airline admin. Okay, so he or she is the person who maintains all the things in the background. Okay, so how many people are traveling in the particular flight, what's the total cost, expenses, how many supply of food. So all the statistics, and that you need to get the ticket in the printed format, like the list of passengers traveling, the all the details in a printed format, in a slip for verification. All the things are done by the backend person of the particular airline, okay, who he or she is working in. So next class is going to be the airline admin. Okay, airline admin. So airline admin will have the, he or she will is also going to have a login panel, separate login panel. User will be like having like a separate login panel. The airline admin will have a separate panel which will be abstracted for the passenger, and they won't be able to see that. So it's same for airline admin as well. So it's going to be name of type string, and another attribute is going to be ID, integer, like a unique reference ID for each admin. Password, you can just put password. I will put email ID as well. So that's it. Basically, I have just added three. It's going to be a type string. It's fine. So these are like the basic attributes for airline admin. And next, operations are quite important, because in case of like any updation in the flight status, it's a due responsibility of the airline admin to like modify the status of the flight. And as well as like the ticket can be bought in two ways. One is by using online method. Otherwise, in some cases you can directly go to that particular airline booking system which is present in the airport, and directly you can like manually buy tickets by paying money. So this two systems should sync, and we need to get as a whole. For example, like if more number of tickets are bought in the offline method, our online system should also, it should get reflected quickly in the online system. Otherwise, like once the ticket is full, the entire capacity is full, and in some case, like if our passenger goes in the online and buys the ticket, it will be like complete chaos. So it should be like quick reflection, quick updation should take place in our system, and all the things are duty of our airline admin. So we'll just go and add our operations. One is going to be the okay updation of info. Okay, in case of any information, it's a duty of our airline admin to do that. And next one is going to be notify passengers. So in case of like anything, if the luggage or other stuff goes missing, in case the passenger is late or not present at the particular time, it is also duty of the airline admin to inform that particular task. And update status. Okay, update status. So this status can be of any type, whether it can be a flight, arrival, departure, it can be like anything. So I think these are like the main classes. Now let me just join all this. Okay, join all this together. So we have the passenger, we have our booking system, we have our admin, so payment. So just go to the data association from passenger to booking system. Passenger payment. The airline admin will have like all the access to our booking system. So, and our flight is also like indirectly connected to our booking system. So I guess that's it. So that's it. We have successfully done a class diagram for online airline ticket booking system, and I've also done many other class diagrams for library management system, shopping system, more activity diagrams, more use case diagrams for like nearly 3 to 4 online systems. So you can do check those videos, and mine is actually a programming channel. I've done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Blender, the distributed animation and Unity. So it'll be really great if you could check my videos of my channel and subscribe and support me. It'll be really helpful and it's absolutely free. And thanks for watching.